Hello children, I am here again to teach you social science of class 5th, chapter 2, that is maps. Let's overview the topics. In the last video, we discussed some topics: meaning of map, types of maps, political map, physical map, and thematic map. In this video, we discuss elements of map. Number 1, directions. Number 2, scale. Number 3, colors. And number 4, symbols.
Elements of map. There are 4 elements of a map. Number 1, directions. Number 2, scale. Number 3, colors. And number 4, symbols. Directions. One of the most important elements of a map is directions. There are 4 major cardinal directions. These are north, south, east, and west. Maps are drawn with north at the top. It is marked as N. This is north. South is at the bottom, as you can see in this map, and east is to the right side. This is the east, and west is to the left side. Children, you know, other than 4 major cardinal directions, there are 4 intermediate directions. These are northeast, southeast, northwest, and southwest. Northeast lies between north and east. Southeast lies between south and east. Southwest lies between south and west. And northwest lies between north and west. Scale. Children, if you look through your atlas, you will see map of countries, continents, or even the whole world. Such a large area are shown on a small sheet of a paper. Do you know how this is done? It is done by making a small distance on paper represent a large distance on the ground. This is done by a scale. So, the scale of a map is the ratio between distance shown on the map and the actual distance on the ground. For example, the actual distance between 2 cities may be 100 kilometers, but on map, it shows 1 centimeter. This means that 1 centimeter on the map represents 100 kilometers on the ground. The scale is generally drawn at the top or at the bottom of the map. Colors. Certain colors are used in maps to show features such as oceans, seas, mountains, plains, deserts, etc. Water bodies are always shown in blue. Deep blue shows deep waters and light blue shows shallow waters. Mountains and highlands are shown in brown and yellow. Dark brown shows high mountains, light brown shows lower mountains and hills. Yellow shows plateaus. Plains and lowlands are shown in green. Symbols. Map shows various features, but it is impossible to show the actual shapes and size of trees, buildings, villages, etc. in a map because of limited space. People all over the world use the same set of symbols, and there is an agreement on these symbols. These are called conventional symbols. So, a symbol is a shape or sign that is used to represent something. The boundaries of a country is shown by a line made up of dots and dashes, as you can see in the picture. One must know about these signs to read the map correctly. So children, that's all for today. Be safe and take care. See you in the next video.